It's a shame that we spend hundreds of billions of dollars each year extracting things like petroleum to make plastics, and we just throw that away and have to re-extract all over again. The big idea with the circular economy is to eventually move away from our extractive nature and instead keep reusing what's already above ground. X is Alphabet's Moonshot Factory, where we tackle the world's biggest challenges using breakthrough technologies. Our goal is to use data and AI to radically change recycling and reuse for all materials and accelerate that path to get to a true circular economy. I'm Ray Benatow, and I'm a director and project lead at X, the Moonshot Factory. My family's originally from the Philippines. My father is an engineer. My mother was in education. I grew up across the street from Apple Computer in Cupertino. So technology, education, and entrepreneurship were always around me growing up. I started skateboarding when I was in sixth or seventh grade. Skateboarding at that time was like counterculture. We were rebellious, we dressed differently. You kind of got used to just being different. And I think that's important because when you're an entrepreneur taking risks, you're gonna always have people telling you you can't do something. And you need to have that type of mindset that actually I can do it. My sustainable materials journey started when I was doing my postdoc at UCLA, where we were re-engineering biology to make new materials for engineering applications. That journey eventually led to me starting my first startup, creating bio-based materials for new sporting goods. Some of these boards are made with bio-based materials, and then others are made with the recyclable material. So this board technically could be recycled at the end of its life. I was already working on projects where I could go help places that didn't have access to better recycling. And that's where I thought, hey, instead of me making new materials, maybe I should be dealing with all the materials that are already made and need a solution.
We're here at our Recycle Central facility in San Francisco at Pier 96. So Recology is a resource recovery company. We aim to create closed-loop resource ecosystems. Everything that enters here goes through an intricate system of conveyors and robotics and technology to be sorted into their different commodities and eventually sold to end markets. As with any system, there's going to be challenges. Over 3/4 of all recyclable materials that are produced don't even make it into the recycling system. Large swaths of the country still don't have access to recycling programs. So we need to create greater uniformity across the entire recycling system and fill in the gaps that we're currently seeing today.
Waste is a data sparse industry. We don't know a lot about materials at the molecular level. They're made up of many different plastic polymers. They're highly formulated with additives and colorants. And by the time you put it into modern packaging, you've combined plastics with paper, with metal. And so they're just really hard to recycle. I thought, well, we have to create our own data collection on all the waste materials that weren't making it into recycling. I'm sitting at home, I have access to my own trash and a little handheld near-infrared scanner. We would cut out little coupons from the trash, label them, take notes in our spreadsheet, and then scan them on this little scanner, getting hundreds of samples categorized. The cool thing about X and what brought me there was just the idea of access to this compute and AI infrastructure at scale. X's moonshot for the circular economy has a vision to realize a world without waste, building what we call a molecular inventory management platform. We We've built a proprietary data set of the world's plastic waste. We're combining new sensors, new imaging techniques, and data and AI to put all of that information together and pull out signatures that tell us that molecular makeup. So the next time we see this object or packaging in the recycling center, we're going to know exactly what's in it and how that's going to be recycled. When you start collecting this amount of data and images, you're gathering thousands to millions of objects in a short amount of time. Having access to a data center that can allow you to accumulate and analyze the largest amounts of data possible, that's a big advantage of being part of Google and Alphabet. Recology has been a great partner the past few years. So if there's a certain type of material that we need to analyze to add to our data set, they're willing to supply that material. They're also willing to test and look at AI and robotics and integrate that into their waste sorting processes. Where today's recycling approaches fall short is that you can't get to 100% recycled material without downgrading its performance. The goal with chemical recycling is to break materials back down to their molecular level and build them back up to get essentially a virgin material back so that you can keep doing that indefinitely. This is all landfill-bound material that we've gotten from partners and granulated it. And then we put this material into the reactor. We essentially distill out the oil. This oil then goes to our partners in the chemical industry, who will then try to turn this back into useful chemicals, materials, even plastics again. Just undo this. Yep. We started by analyzing plastic waste, but eventually we want to do this for all materials, things like textiles, electronics, batteries, accelerate recycling and circularity for all of those industries. My hope is that humanity is a lot smarter about what we do with our environment and the world's materials and everything that we need to make modern society function. Oftentimes, these world's biggest challenges end up being system-level problems where not just one technology can solve it. You don't just get to the moon in one shot, but that combination of huge problem, radical solution, and breakthrough technology, to us, is where a moonshot starts.